Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today we are going to discuss one more interview question, that is how to check the Armstrong numbers. So what is Armstrong number and how we can check it? So let's move to next slide to understand about the Armstrong number. So here as we can see the first number, that is 153. So first we need to get the length of this, so that would be 3. Then we need to take the separate numbers, that is 1, 5 and 3. Then we need to take the power with the length, that would be 3. And then we need to add those numbers. If that number will be equals to 153, that is existing number, then that would be Armstrong numbers, otherwise not. As we can see in the last, that would be 1634. So length of this is 4 and we need to take the separate characters, that would be 1, 6, 3 and 4. Then we need to take the power with the 4 and then we need to add those numbers. If that number will be equals to our input number, that is 1634, that would be Armstrong number. So here we need to write a function that will accept a parameter with the number, and we need to write our logic inside the function. If that number is Armstrong number, then we just want to print the Armstrong number, otherwise we need to print the given number is not Armstrong number. So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio, where we will write the query and we can get the output. So here I am using SQL 2017. So you may have another version of SQL Server. So first of all, I would like to declare a variable that would be our input variable. So we can say like input and it would be varchar type and this is 100. Now we can set the value like 153 inside this variable. Now I need to declare few more variables. So next variable would be length. Data type would be integer and we can set the value of this variable length of our input. Now need to declare one more variable, that would be final variable. So in the final variable it will be going to combine the result set. Then I need to declare one more variable, that would be I, and initial value we can set as length of our input. So we have done our variables. Now we need to write our logic. So first of all we need to use while loop. If this @i value is greater than 0, this loop will be executed. And here we can write begin then end. So here we can set @final variable should be equals to @final plus. Here we need to take the power with each characters. So we can use power and here we need to fetch out one by one. So we can use substring. So this is substring function, and inside the substring function we just want to get values from the input. So this is input. Then we can specify @i and we just want only one character. We can put comma and here we can use @length. Next we just want to decrease the value of this @i variable. So @i minus 1. Now we have done our loop. So what we are going to deal with this loop. So here we will calculate the length of this input. So length variable will hold 3 and this I will also going to hold 3. So here it will be going to start from input, that is 153, and here that is 3. We need to pull only one character. So it will be going to get 3 at the first time. And here we have length, that is 3. So 3 to power 3 in the first execution. Then in the second execution it will be going to pick second character. And in the third execution, it will be going to pick the first character. And it will be going to add those values into @final. Now we can check. So here we can use if @input is equals to @final. So that value will be Armstrong number. So we can use begin. And so we can print the message like given number is Armstrong and if these values is not going to equal, then we can print given number is not Armstrong. So here we can use print given number is not Armstrong. Now we can execute. So given number is Armstrong, that is good. Now we can change this number. Given number is not Armstrong. Now we need to put this into a function. So we can create a function. So that would be the function, and it would be fn dot get strong, and it will be going to accept a parameter. So we can call this as input, and data type would be varchar, and it is 100. Now we have to specify the returns and data type. So this is varchar and 100. Now we can use as, then we can use begin. Now it looks good, but here we need to make some changes. So this else statement shouldn't be there. Now it looks good, and here we have already declared the input parameter, so we have to comment this. Now let me execute this. So now function is created. Let me copy this, and we just want to check it's working fine or not. So select, and here we can use dbo dot or function, and here we can specify the value. So first of all 153. Now we can execute. Given number is Armstrong, then 143. Given number is not Armstrong, so it's working fine. Now 100, now it looks good. Then we can check for last value, that is 1634. Execute. So given number is Armstrong. So this is the code, and this is very simple if you can understand step by step. So this is the function as we have created. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. If you need this script, it will be available on the description of this video, so you can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.